X-ray crystallography is a tool used for identifying the atomic and molecular structure of a crystal, in which the crystalline atoms cause a beam of incident X-rays to diffract into many specific directions. Analysis of the intensity and angles of diffraction of the beams allows investigators to produce a three-dimensional representation of the electrons within the crystal, which in turn allows them to determine the positioning of the atoms, their chemical bonds, and further information regarding their structure. Because many different materials can form crystals, the application of this knowledge is applicable in numerous scientific fields, and although it has been around for quite some time, it is still the principal method used to analyze new materials and for differentiating between materials that may appear similar through other experiments. So how does it work? There are two key components to the method of X-ray crystallography: the crystal and the X-rays. Crystal is a solid material in which the atoms and molecules are connected together in a regular repeated pattern called the crystal lattice, the study of which is known as crystallography. X-rays are a form of electromagnetic radiation. They are invisible and have a wavelength ranging from 1 to 100 angstroms, an angstrom being a unit of length equivalent to 1/10 billionth of a meter. For the structure of proteins to be visualized, electromagnetic radiation of wavelength 1 angstrom must be used. X-rays approximate to this, and as such, are used for crystallography because they have short enough wavelengths that they are able to see the atoms and the molecular structure of molecules. Because of this, X-ray crystallography is particularly useful as a technique for obtaining high-resolution protein structural information. In 1912, Max von Laue, a German physicist, first postulated that the crystalline structure could be used to diffract X-rays based on the following assumptions. 1. The atomic lattice of a crystal is periodic, i.e. the lattice pattern is repeated throughout the crystal. 2. X-rays are electromagnetic radiation and thus are able to diffract. 3. That the interatomic distances of a crystal are of the same magnitude as the wavelength of X-ray light. His colleagues Walter Friedrich and Paul Nipping tested his idea by bombarding a crystal of zinc sulfide, successfully managing to obtain a diffraction pattern on a photographic film. And they showed that the interference in the emitted X-rays was caused by some X-rays reflecting from the lower levels or adjacent atomic levels. British physicist Sir William Henry Bragg and his son Sir William Lawrence Bragg developed an X-ray spectrometer to systematically study the diffraction of X-rays from crystal surfaces. They proposed that due to the short wavelength of X-rays, the rays were able to penetrate the surface and reflect from the atomic lattice planes within the crystal itself. In their experiment, parallel beams of X-ray radiation were fired from an X-ray tube at a sample of sodium chloride. They used an ionization chamber to detect the scattered X-rays, enabling them to determine the position and intensity of the diffracted rays. They observed the scattering of X-rays, with parallel rays constructively and destructively interfering, forming intensity maximums and minimums. Thus, they concluded that the X-rays were reflected from regularly spaced parallel planes of the crystal that were formed by the arrangement of atoms in the crystal lattice, making it possible to view the arrangement of atoms within a solid material, a feat never previously achieved. As a consequence of their experiment, they developed Bragg's law. Bragg's law derives the relationship between the spacing of the crystal planes, the wavelength of the radiation, and the angle of reflection. It is used to calculate interplanar spacing used in X-ray diffraction spectra. It defines the spacing of atomic planes and incident angle at which X-rays of a particular wavelength will reflect in phase. When a crystal is irradiated by an X-ray beam, Bragg's law allows scientists to predict the angle at which diffracted intensities can be expected, or conversely, to calculate the corresponding interplanar spacing in the crystal and determine the structure of the lattice. Thus, X-ray crystallography has a range of applications in the wider world. By providing analysis of protein ligand complexes, it has provided the means to study the interactions between drugs and their protein targets at an atomic level, allowing for the development and improvement of many different drugs. As well as this, X-ray crystallography has played an important role in dairy science and is a tool widely used for the elucidation of compounds present in milk. As such, X-ray crystallography is an important tool for studying the atomic structure of crystals.